What's up, guys? It's your boy, and I'm trying out the Lone Wolf 8-Ball EQ, using it again on my Paul Reed Smith MT-15. Let's go try this puppy out. All right, guys, so I'm using the red channel, and again, usual bass, mid, and treble at noon, and then I'm going to use the EQ to just play around with it, so... This is with the pedal off. Okay, so I just figured out this pedal. It is, in a very simple way to put it, if you've ever used an MXR 10-band EQ, this is basically an 8-band EQ where instead of sliders, you have knobs. So it's in the same ballpark. So instead of a 10-band EQ, it's basically an 8-band EQ. Again, if you've ever used an EQ, maybe the guy from Lone Wolf is going to be like, yo, it's nothing like the MXR 10-band. Yes, it is. Yes, it is. It's just not mass-produced. You know what I mean? Like, so if you're all about not going to McDonald's or Burger King, and you rather would go to a local restaurant where you walk in and you meet the owner, you meet his wife, you meet their kids because they work there, then that's what this is. You know what I mean? Like, you know, it's not MXR where you have, it's not Electro-Harmonix where you have dozens and dozens of people that work for a company and it's a corporate entity. This is literally a guy who makes his own pedals. So if you get them, then more power to you. I think that's awesome. You're basically, you know, I'm a small business owner also. So you're basically helping the small business owner. So instead of giving your money to MXR, you could just give your money to the owner of Lone Wolf Audio. And you can actually find him on Facebook. I know he has a photo with himself. Does he have a little dog in the photo? What does he have? I forgot. It's like him and something that he's holding. Big beard guy. Big guy. Like, even in his photos, he looks like he's 6'5". So, but that's, you know, you're supporting the small business owner. You know, and as much as people think of KHDK as being this huge entity, it's really not. You know, it's just some financial backing from some guy you've never heard of named Kirk Hammett, and then Dave Caron that basically runs the show. So it's the same thing. You know, you're supporting, you know, it's like Tony Peppers. It's like, you know, from Pepper's Petals in New Zealand. It's like Jordan Gale, who owns Highwind Amplification. You know, it's the same thing. So if you're all about helping literally guitarists who make pedals, and, you know, these aren't guys who are selling pedals and using the money to buy themselves a $10 million mansion. These are guys who have little kids. You know, like talking to Tony Peppers, he's like, dude, I have my little son take all the pedals with a bag. He puts it in the bag. He seals it for him. And that's his job. You know what I mean? Like, yo, if you're not supporting small business, then I don't know what to tell you. You know, of course, Paul Reed Smith is a huge company. But there's so many, you know, small companies that, you know, will go ahead and for the same price, for half the price of this guitar, will basically make you this guitar with woods that are significantly more exotic than what this Paul Reed Smith Custom 22 has. So support your small businesses in this industry, because that's where it is now. So if you're trying to look for an absolutely awesome EQ pedal, definitely check out the, you know, this, the 8-Ball EQ. You're really going to like it. And listen, again, if you haven't subscribed, hit the subscribe button. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll talk to you guys soon.